The only place you can see it is live on Channel 5. Vermont Daily Numbers Drawing, Monday through Friday at 7:30 p.m. and coverage of Saturday's drawing at 8:30 on WPTZ, Plattsburgh, North Pole, Burlington.
Yes, it's the Newlywed Game. Now let's meet our newlywed couples for today. Couple number one, married just 12 months, Lana and Tom McDonald. Couple number two, married just 5 months, Linda and Mustique Sabour. Couple number three, married just 11 short weeks, Mary Jo and Jim Nairley. And couple number four, married just 6 months, Teresa and Richard Wallstrom Jr. Those are our Newlywed for today. Here's your host, the star of the Newlywed Game, Bob Eubanks.
And welcome to the Newlywed Game. We've all been married less than 2 years. That's what there has to be here on the Newlywed Game. That's what makes it Newlyweds. And by the way, thanks to all of you people in New Orleans, Louisiana, who watch our show on WVUE-TV. We'll be back in just a moment, so don't go away.
Once in a generation, Walt Disney Pictures creates an enchanted universe never before imagined. An astounding vision that will never be equaled. Now, Walt Disney Pictures presents a new dimension in modern animation. An epic adventure for now and evermore. The Black Cauldron. The all-new and 25th motion picture classic from Walt Disney Pictures.
Wow. Now playing. Check local listings for theaters and times.
We asked whisk users to test whisk against this new liquid. And here's what some of them said.
Whisk has been getting out ring around the collar for years. Now that's a test.
Test whisk? No.
Whisk always passes every test in my wash.
Some new detergent in a fancy package isn't going to get me to switch.
Yes. Test? I've got three tests right here that prove whisk works.
For 25 years, nothing has beaten the ring around the collar power of whisk.
Who needs a test? I trust whisk.
Street violence in Burlington's North End. Will it lead to a gun control law in the city? And Post 20 took on the Legion Squad from Proctor, Vermont. We're looking on last night's action.
Southerly breezes, but hot, hazy, and humid.
Tonight at 6.
Nestled in the heart of the beautiful Adirondacks is one of America's finest regional museums, the Adirondack Museum. Depicting man's relationship to the Adirondacks in 20 separate exhibition buildings. Open June 15th to October 15th. Visit the Adirondack Museum, Blue Mountain Lake.
Jeopardy, America's premier game of trivia, is back with hundreds of thousands in cash to be awarded as host Alex Trebek hands out the dough.
Who is Alex Trebek?
Alex Trebek is his name, and Jeopardy is his game.
I don't think I could have said it any better myself.
Jeopardy, weekdays at 5 p.m. on Channel 5.
Secluded safely offstage, it's time for some five-point questions. As you know, gentlemen, you'll be answering these questions. As you predict, your wife will answer the same question when she returns. If her answer matches your prediction, you'll get 5 points toward a special grand prize that's been selected especially for you. So listen carefully. Remember, each question's worth 5 points. Each correct prediction brings you that much closer to that grand prize. And if you're ready, here's your first question for 5 points. Gentlemen, on what date will your wife say the two of you were married? I want the month, the day, and the year. Richard?
That's an easy one.
Good.
October 15th, 1977.
Almost Play wasn't six. That easy. October 15th, 77. Tim?
I know she'll get it wrong. It's going to be February 4th, 1978.
February 4th, 78. Musique?
October 29th, 78.
October 29th, 1978. Tom?
April 8th, 1977.
April 8th, 77. Next question, gentlemen. What will your wife say is the sequence in which these three events occurred? Okay? In what sequence did these three events occur? She stopped seeing her last boyfriend. You stopped seeing your last girlfriend. The two of you first made whoopee. Now, which occurred first, Tim?
She stopped seeing her last boyfriend.
That's first. Then what was second?
I stopped seeing my last girlfriend, and we made whoopee.
Okay. She stopped seeing the boy, you stopped seeing the girl, and bingo.
Right.
Right. Musique, which took place first?
She stopped seeing her
last boyfriend. Yes.
And I stopped seeing my girlfriend.
Okay.
And we made whoopee.
All right, fine. Tom?
I stopped seeing my last girlfriend.
You stopped seeing the last girlfriend first?
And then she stopped seeing her last boyfriend, and
all right.
Then we made whoopee.
Okay. Richard?
I stopped seeing my last girlfriend, then she stopped seeing her boyfriend, and then Whoopi.
Right. Last of our five-point questions. Gentlemen, tell me where specifically will your wife say the two of you were the very first time you ever bathed together? Where were you? Music?
In our apartment.
In your apartment. Okay. Tom?
I'd be in our apartment.
In your apartment also. Richard?
In our apartment. Yes.
In the apartment. Tim?
In the apartment I was living in when we first started dating.
That's before or after you stopped seeing your last girlfriend. I see. The one that you were living in when you were dating, then,
yes.
Right? Okay, fine. Gentlemen, thank you very much. We'll be right back to reunite these newlyweds, and we'll see how well the husbands have predicted what their wives will say. First of all, though, we do have some gifts for our runner-up couples.
Our three runner-up couples will receive American Tourister strong, lightweight luggage, good-looking protection that keeps your clothes looking good. American Tourister, the only way to travel. And Beechnut, the baby food with no sugar added to any jar. Isn't your baby sweet enough? Beechnut for new ideas in baby nutrition. And from the Jovan collection for men, musk oil, sex appeal, Monsieur Jovan, and sports scent for men. And Blue Ribbon almonds, whole, blanched, sliced, or slivered. Blue Ribbon is nuts, fine California almonds. Now back to Bob Eubanks.
Okay, gentlemen, we've recorded your predictions on cards and now have them in your laps. Every time that your prediction matches your wife's answer, you'll be given 5 points. And then the one couple with the most points at the end of the show naturally wins the grand prize. That's easy to figure out, isn't it? Here's our first question for 5 points. Ladies, tell me, on what date were the two of you married? I want the month, the day, and the year. Alana?
April 8th, 1977.
April 8th, 77. He said April 8th, 77. You get it right, you get 5 points. Linda?
October 29th,
1977. 77. He said the 29th of October, 1978.
Oh, baby. 77!
Well, Zeke, if you can keep those cards flat on your lap and use your right arm to protect yourself.
Oh, right.
You see.
I know I'm right, but you should have got that right.
Mary Jo?
February 4th, 78.
February 4th, 78. He said February 4th, 78. Yes, you did get it right. Terry?
Well, if he doesn't know this one, October 15th, 1977.
All right, he said October 15th, 1977. Next question, girls, tell me, what is the sequence in which these three events occurred, okay? Which came first, second, and third? You stopped seeing your last boyfriend. He stopped seeing his last girlfriend. You made Whoopi. Now, what is the sequence that all of that occurred? Linda, we'll start with you. What happened first?
I stopped seeing my boyfriend.
You stopped seeing your last boyfriend, then?
And he stopped seeing his girlfriend.
Uh-huh.
And then we made Whoopi.
Okay, he said that you stopped seeing, he stopped seeing, and Whoopi! You got it right. Okay. Mary Jo, what happened first?
Let's see, I stopped seeing.
You stopped seeing?
Then him.
Then you stopped seeing him?
No, I stopped seeing.
Oh, you stopped seeing your last boyfriend. Then he stopped seeing, yes.
And then Whoopi.
Right, okay. He predicted you would say that, yes, you stopped, he stopped, and Whoopi. Correct. Terry. What's so funny?
Well, the last time I saw my boyfriend, he was at the movie, the same movie that he was at with his girlfriend. So,
What happened first?
Well, he didn't see me, but I saw him at the movie, and the next day we went to this picnic, and anyway, I had it on my mind all day, and I told him that night, and he got really embarrassed. But anyway, he...
Oh, okay. It's a soap opera. You guys write this down?
I stopped seeing my boyfriend, then he stopped seeing his, and then...
You stopped seeing your boyfriend, then he stopped seeing his boyfriend?
Right. No, his girlfriend.
Oh, I see. You stopped, he stopped, and Whoopi, right? Okay, he predicted you would say that, he stopped,
yes,
and you stopped.
Yes, I stopped first.
You stopped.
Or maybe you didn't tell me.
I told you that night when we went to the show.
But you didn't stop, remember?
Yes, I did. That was the last day.
It was a couple weeks later, I remember.
No.
Can you get her to stop seeing that guy?
It took some work.
Alana?
Tom
says that he didn't have any girlfriends before.
Well, Tom told us differently.
Well, anyway, he stopped seeing his last girlfriend, I stopped seeing my last boyfriend, and then whoopee.
Okay, he predicted you would say he stopped, you stopped, and whoopee, that's right. Okay. Next question, last of our five-pointers. Girls, where specifically were the two of you the very first time you ever bathed together? Where were you the first time you ever bathed together, Mary Jo?
Apartment-wise, or... Well, I guess it would have to be... the address?
No, I just want to know, you know, whose apartment.
Oh,
if
okay.
It's an apartment, or
oh, okay.
Where?
Okay, his apartment in... What, it, Huntington Beach?
His apartment, all right. He predicted you say it was his old apartment. That's correct. You get the point. Good for you.
You better get the word.
Terry, where were you?
In San Francisco.
Whereabouts in San Francisco?
In a hotel.
At a hotel in San Francisco. Ah, Richard, you told us a story. He
no,
said it was
no.
in your apartment, the apartment you have now, I guess.
Right. We didn't, not in San Francisco.
I can't remember.
It was in our apartment, I'm right. I'm sure.
I can't remember.
Well, wait a minute. She says you bathed together in San Francisco in a hotel.
We were in San Francisco in a hotel, but...
Why'd you swallow so hard, Richard?
I know, I'm right. We did not bathe together. It was in our apartment.
Okay.
No. Alana?
Could this be sunbathing?
No, huh?
We don't bathe together, I guess. Do couples do that? Our apartment, our first
apartment. Your apartment, okay.
Yes.
Tom predicted you would say it was in your apartment.
Your
that's correct.
Yeah,
okay.
Give it to you.
What's the matter, Tom?
She's the one who says, come in and give me a bath, you know, rub her back and that kind of stuff. So I got
But you don't do it with me. I mean, you know.
Yeah, every once in a while you pull me in, you know. Like,
I don't, you know.
Welcome.
What, but I don't pull him in? There's not enough room.
Oh. That's true. Linda?
You know, I know, but he probably... In our apartment.
In your apartment. He
yeah.
predicted you say in your apartment.
Right,
that's correct.
Right.
Okay. Well, thank you very much. We'll be back with the wives. We'll see how well they predict what the husbands will say right after this brief message.
McDonald's found a whole new way to eat chicken. Grab the number one nugget and start dipping. McDonald's Chicken McNuggets dipping with the best. Cause those tender chunks of breast and thigh are a step ahead of the rest. And not a lot of calories, number one. Like right finger food fun.
Fun, fun.
It's the good time for the great taste. McDonald's tell you one thing, we really started something. A McDonald's.
A word of advice. Beware of the imitators. Clear soft drinks that compare themselves to 7-Up. The one and only Uncooler. The real test lies with you, the people. And you buy more 7-Up than all other clear soft drinks combined. Ah, let them compare all they want. You have made 7-Up number one. Ha ha ha. The people have spoken and the choice is clear. The Uncooler. Ah.
Come visit downtown Burlington for the magical Church Street Festival of the Arts, July 26th through the 28th. Over 100 juried craft designers will be displaying and selling excellent contemporary craft work. Jazz and entertainment daily. Exhibits are under tents, rain or shine. Plentiful parking and free admission. The Church Street Festival of the Arts, July 26th through the 28th. Official program in the Vanguard Press. Don't miss the event of the season.
All right, ladies, now it's your turn to predict what your husbands will say. And remember, these will be our 10-point questions. First question, girls, during your wedding ceremony, will your husband say he had more trouble dealing with the words, the ring, or the kiss? What did he have more trouble dealing with, Mary Jo?
Oh, it's easy, the ring, because I have a habit sometimes of cracking my knuckles. And so I have kind of big knuckles, and it's hard
couldn't
to
get the ring on.
Right.
Fine. Linda?
The words.
The words he had trouble with. Alana?
Well, I'm always complaining about my husband not being able to communicate very well, so I'd have to say the words.
He had trouble with the words. Terry?
The kiss.
What was the problem, Terry?
He was so nervous, just like me.
All right. Next question, girls. How will your husband say you would complete this sentence using one of the four main compass directions? My husband spends more time traveling blank than any other direction. Linda.
I'd have to say north because he's always going back out that way for something. He, you know, everything is back out that way.
Does he ever come back?
Yeah, you know, like the next day. But...
Oh, the next day. Oh, all right. He goes north. Atlanta?
Being we live so close to the ocean, I'd have to say east.
He goes
going
east.
Going back east, right.
Fine. Terry?
North.
He spends a lot of time going north.
Yeah. Don't ask me why. He goes north. That's the only one I could think of that That's... he would say.
Mary Jo?
South.
He spends a lot of time going south.
Down south.
Okay. Last of our 10-point questions. Girls, thinking back to the very first spot at which the two of you ever made whoopee, will your husband say that spot was comfortable or uncomfortable? Alana?
Oh, it was comfortable.
Comfortable. Terry?
Very, very uncomfortable.
It was uncomfortable?
Yes. That's all.
That's all what?
That's all I'm going to say is that it was uncomfortable.
Really bad uncomfortable. What was the problem?
No.
Mary Jo?
Very comfortable.
It was comfortable?
Yes. Hmm. Very good.
Linda, when I asked this question, you went, oh.
It was comfortable, but it was terrible.
I'm sorry. 25-point bonus question. Girls, what will your husband say was the year and make of your getaway car? The year and make of your getaway car. Terry?
Oh, gee. It was a... I can't even remember. I would have to say the Mustang. A Mustang, 77 Mustang.
77 Mustang, all right. Mary Jo?
73 Lincoln.
73 Lincoln. Linda?
Where will we be going?
I don't know. Get away.
Just getting away?
This is the getaway car, you know.
Oh.
Like all couples have a getaway car.
Oh, I'd say 75 Toyota.
75 Toyota, all right.
Yeah.
Alana?
Gee, I don't know cars and years or anything like that. A green car.
Was it comfortable or uncomfortable? No, never mind.
76 Monza.
76 Monza. All right, ladies, thank you very much. We'll be back with the husbands in a moment. We'll compare answers on the Newlywed Game in a moment. First of all, we do have some more gifts for our runner-up couples.
Our three runner-up couples will receive an assortment of Daisy Home products, including the Seal-A-Meal, the Donut Maker 4, and the new Power Scrubber, all furnished by Daisy. Plus, discover the taste of Jolly Time, the popcorn lover's popcorn, always light, crisp, and delicious. Next time, make it Jolly Time. Plus, cup of noodles loaded with noodles, plus vegetables and seasoning in a rich, hearty broth. Five flavors, twin pack, and regular size cup of noodles. Plus, True Test Easy Care Latex Flat Enamel combines the flat finish of latex with the scrubability of enamel. Exclusively from True Value Hardware Stores. Now back to Bob Eubanks and those unpredictable newlyweds.
Now, gentlemen, let's see how well your wives have predicted what you will say. Remember, these questions will now be worth 10 points. First question for 10 points. Gentlemen, during your wedding ceremony, did you have more trouble dealing with the words, the ring, or the kiss? This is during your wedding ceremony, Musique. What'd you have trouble with? The words, the ring, or the kiss?
I'd have to say the words.
The words. She said you had more trouble with the words. Right. Okay, Tim?
That's easy. Even the minister is trying to help me. The ring.
The ring. She said it was the ring. Right. Richard?
Had to be the kiss.
There's a kiss? What happened?
Well, after the ring, we... didn't know what to do. You know, there was a pause, and it had to be the kiss.
There was applause after the ring?
Yeah. The ring was no problem.
No, okay. She predicted you had trouble with the kiss. Well, Tom, which one did you have trouble with?
I'd have to say the kiss, because after the ring, you're all done. You know, you just, the minister doesn't tell you to
that's
do
right.
anymore.
After the ring, you're all done,
oh,
for sure.
Always...
the words is what you had trouble with.
I was good.
You did the kiss okay. That was the best part.
heart.
No, you said...
That's all I remember. Okay.
She said you have a problem communicating with her.
That's good. You know, the words are fed out. The guy tells you exactly what to do. Okay? So you do all the right words, and she says, but... you did a good job in the words. You know, that's no
but
problem.
But your
just
voice
read
was
them.
Quivering. I thought no, you were going back.
Sorry.
Next question for 10 points. Gentlemen, how did your wife complete this sentence? Using one of the four main compass directions. She said, my husband spends more time traveling blank than any other direction. You spend more time traveling blank than any other direction. Tim.
She says, I've got my head in the sand and I'm always going south.
South. She said, you're going south. Right? Richard.
I'd have to say west.
You spend a lot of time going west.
Yeah, because we're close to the ocean. And, you know,
sure, all right. She said you spend a lot of time going north.
Why north?
West?
What's north?
I don't know. I just said north because it's the only thing I could think of.
Well, I didn't think of north.
Tom?
I do a lot of traveling, but it's mostly towards the east because we're right close to the ocean, so everything else is east of us.
She said it's east. Yeah, it's east. I understand, Tom. If you go east, how do you get back?
I come back west.
Don't you spend as much time going west then as east?
No, because I don't go back as far.
We communicated, that's all that counts. Don't come back.
Oh, he doesn't
nothing.
Go back as far. Sitting on that. Music?
I'm going to say north, but I know she's probably going to say going
north.
Nowhere.
She predicted you'd say north. Okay, here's the last of our 10-point questions. Gentlemen, tell me, thinking way back to the very first spot in which the two of you ever made whoopee, was that spot comfortable or uncomfortable? Richard, thinking back to the first time the two of you ever made whoopee, was it comfortable or?
Definitely uncomfortable.
Uncomfortable, right.
Definitely. Oh.
Why was it so uncomfortable, Richard?
Well, my knees. My knees got a little sore. I had sore knees.
I see. Tom?
Well, it was in a hotel, so it was comfortable.
Comfortable. She said it was very comfortable. Was he?
I'd have to say it was very comfortable.
Very comfortable. She said it was comfortable. And Tim?
Well, even with all the people around, it was comfortable.
What
it
do you
was
mean?
Comfortable. She said it was comfortable. All right. Okay. Couples, thank you very much. We'll be back with the 25-point bonus question to see which couple is going to win their grand prize right after this message. All right, gentlemen, here it is, your big 25-point bonus question for 25 points. Gentlemen, tell me, what was the year and the make of your getaway car? I want the year and the make of your getaway car. Let's go first to couple number four, Richard and Terry. Not doing too bad, really. You got 25 points. If you got this one right, you'll have 50 points. Richard?
I know she won't get the date right.
Well, she might.
Well, maybe. It was a 1964 Jaguar.
64 Jag.
Yeah.
All right. You're right, Richard. She said it was, the card, please, a 77 Mustang.
A what? We never had a Mustang.
Yes, we did. We had the Unicorn. We had the Mustang.
That was no getaway car. The Jaguar was the getaway car.
Double number one, Tom, in Atlanta, you have 35. 25 will give you 60. Tom, you can take over the lead with the correct answer.
Here's my car, 76 Monza.
76 Monza, that's what she said. It was a 76 Monza. All right, couple number two, Linda and Muzik. You have 40 points. 25 would give you 65. Muzik, what's your answer?
1975 Toyota.
A 75 Toyota, that's what she said it was. Okay, you've all done pretty well. Tim and Mary Jo, you have 45 points. That means that you've answered every question thus far on the Newlywed Game. So if you get this one right, you'll have a total of 70 points and a perfect score. And along with that perfect score, you'll also win a grand prize that's been selected especially for you and your wife, Tim. So if you get it right, you'll be in first place and win that prize. What's your answer?
You don't put the pressure on. 1973 Lincoln.
73 Lincoln. She says it was a 73 Lincoln. That's right. Tim and Mary Jo, you're our Newlywed Game grand prize winner. And now, winners of the Newlywed Game, here's the special prize chosen just for you. Your very own brand new, exquisitely designed living room. That's right, Joe and Kim. It's a brand new Broy Hill traditional living room. The Riviera Collection, including a 90-inch pillowback sofa, love-seated chair, a new exciting cocktail table, and two end tables in the bamboo look from Broy Hill. Here's the final touch of elegance, a stately, proud grandfather clock with moving dial and Westminster chimes from the Emperor Clock Company. A complete and elegant living room ensemble, all for you from the Newlywed Game. Tim and Mary Jo, congratulations to being our winners. Thanks to all of our couples for being with us. Thanks to you, too. By the way, I want to say hi to everybody in Memphis, Tennessee, who watched the Newlywed Game on WREG. I'm Bob Eubanks. We'll see you next time. Goodbye for now.
Tonight on The Cosby Show, can the family survive the attack of the Mad Repairman? And on Family Ties, everybody's going baby crazy. Then it's Cheers, and on Night Court, it's Harry's birthday. Then on Hill Street Blues, will a vicious attack on a scholar athlete go unpunished? Then at 11, join Donna Kirker, Rick Whitlow, and Bird Burdan for Nightly News on 5.
Summer is here, and whatever you need for your summer fun, you can find it at the North Country Shopping Center, located on Route 9, Plattsburgh, just north of Northway Exit 39.